It's been 6 years. I've won.
Well, I guess this is it. After, like, 3 months, I guess, it all comes down to this final battle.
It's only been 3 days! I know being around you makes it seem like longer, but where the hell did you get that from?
Perception of time isn't important to a hero, Navi. What is important is winning. Otherwise, all the good I've done for so many people will have all been for nothing.
You haven't helped a single person! If anything, you've made the lives of everyone you've met slightly worse! Or significantly worse! Or made them be over!
That's not true. Remember whenever I found that innkeeper lady's missing fiancé?
So, you're the fairy boy's been asking all over Clocktown about Cafe. Well, Mr. Detective, it seems you found your man, for I am Cafe.
No way! That's impossible!
That's right. The Cafe we're looking for is a grown man. You're clearly a child.
The what? Oh yeah, that. But also, he can't be Cafe because... I am Cafe.
No, you're not. Where the hell did you even get that thing? Doesn't even look human.
My God. Those empty eye sockets. Those unmoving features. The complete lack of a nose? He looks exactly like me. But if he's me, then who am I?
What? You're you, you moron.
Me? A moron? I've heard there's only one person the fairy folk would call a moron. I must be Link, the hero of time.
No. No, no, no. One of those is bad enough. Look, he's Link, you are Cafe. He's just wearing a mask that vaguely looks like you.
A mask?
That looks this lifelike?
Navi, you're so crazy.
It's funny because he had an identity crisis.
How does that count as helping someone?
Because now Termina has two heroes looking out for it. Trust me, no harm could possibly come from this.
Meanwhile...
Free scoundrels, this is a citizen's arrest. And you can put down those guns. You're impressing no one.
Spy with my little eye, something beginning with V.
I don't care.
Come on, man, we've been up here doing nothing for days. I'm so bored, I'm starting to wonder if my voice is racist or not.
Ugh, fine. Let's see. V. Is it...
Woohoo! We made it!
Victim.
No, man, it was very big pigeon. Freeze, skullkid. This is a citizen's arrest. And you can put down that moon. You're impressing no one.
Oh, I'll put it down, all right.
Really? Navi, we won! He said he'd put down the moon!
Him putting the moon down is the entire problem, you idiot!
Oh, right, I forgot that's how crushing things works. Well, surrender, Skull Kid, and put it back up again, then!
And why would I do that?
Because if you don't, you'll have a giant problem. Guardian Giants, assemble! All right, team, it's time to save the town. The way only a giant can.
Hooray for the giants! Yes, they're here to save all 6 of us! Long live the- Oh god, he crushed my house! Now they're crushing the hospital! And the orphanage! And the nuclear power station! Why did we ever build those next to each other?
Okay, we've got the moon. Now's your chance to defeat Skull Kid and restore peace to the... the thing that you have to restore peace to. Town or whatever. Well, guess my job's done. See you guys later.
What?
You're not gonna fight him?
Well, no. The moon's not falling anymore. So why would I?
Because then we'd have to stay here and hold the moon forever!
Is that a problem?
It weighs 73 quintillion tons!
Yeah, I might chip a nail.
Fine. If it'll make you happy, I guess I'll be a professional hero. Now time to murder this child.
Well, well. Sounds like someone's found some baseless confidence.
Well, why shouldn't I be confident? I've found your weakness. I'm the hero of time, and you're just some kid with a magic mask. All I have to do is knock that off,
and you'll be left with no power at all.
My God, the Mask of Majora has freed itself from its host. Now it's no longer bound by the limitations of the human form.
Now the goddesses themselves shall cower before my might.
Well...
Now, Luna, use your teleportation fire.
Damn, he's escaping. How are we gonna get...
I'll get you, Skull.
Oh, God, it burns! Why did nobody tell me fire burns?
I think we're on the moon.
Huh. It's got a lot greener since the 60s.
Oh God, I can't believe we're actually gonna fight a possessed demon mask on the moon. My horoscope was right.
Oh, relax. It's not that bad.
Not that bad. Need I remind you that this mask has limitless magical power and only desires the destruction of all living things. How while we're here, it could use its magic to look like anything or anyone. It could be a blade of grass, a cloud, a puff of smoke. It could be your hat right now. It could kill us without us ever knowing it was he!
Hello there!
Oh, hi, first ever alien that anyone's ever met. You haven't seen a magical evil mask anywhere, have you?
That's him, you dimwit!
What? Me? No. That Majora guy is just a mask. Whereas I'm a mask and a body. A body that totally isn't an illusion to fool feeble mortal minds like yours. I mean ours. Feeble and pathetic.
Yeah, these things aren't what they used to be.
The fool will never see through my perfect disguise. Perfect and without flaw. Because that's what perfect means. I have thought of everything.
So, what's your name, friend?
Ah, crap. Oh, I'm the head of Clocktown's military. You can just call me the Major. Major A.S., Mask.
Major A.S. Mask? Why, you sound like just the guy to help us beat Majora's Mask.
You cannot seriously be falling for this!
Oh, I see you've got quite a few masks of power there. Would you mind handing those over?
Why?
Because they'd be much more useful in the hands of the military than with you. I mean, sure. One person used the masks of power, they might technically stand the teensiest, tiniest chance of victory. But if an army uses them, we're practically guaranteed victory against the great and powerful Majora, the Eater of Worlds and Master of the Moon, who shall bring Terminath salvation through destruction.
Okay, that's a good point. Here you go.
Don't give him those, he'll kill us all!
Oh, please, Navi. I think we can trust the Major.
Thank you, fool.
Wait a minute. I don't think you're the Major at all.
You fools! Your trusted friend, Major A.S. Mask, was really me! Majora's Mask, all along!
Whoa, what a cunning disguise!
That wasn't cunning at all! In fact, it wasn't even a disguise!
Man, he sure had both of us fooled.
No, he didn't!
Yes, now I am all powerful. And I have all of your masks. Without them, boy, you're nothing.
Close, Majora. You have all of my masks, except one.
Wait, what?
During my journey, I found a particularly powerful mask. The mask said to be the most powerful in all of Termina.
No, it can't be. It was supposed to be lost forever. He can't have found the only mask with power that exceeds my own. The mask of the legendary, fierce
ghost scent mask!
How in the hell is that supposed to help us?
I don't know. It's been useless up until this point, so I figured it must be one of those plot items for taking down the final boss.
All it does is slightly heighten your sense of smell. How's that supposed to help you beat someone who can pull the moon out of orbit?
Well, Oh, I've got it! Now that my sense of smell has improved, I can now sniff out his weakness. Huh. Smells like he doesn't have one.
A
No, this is supposed to be host the episode, and it's there enough of you who's still be hard and with the stolen episode. That's the only way Sloppy Dog will ever lose to Majora's Mask. He has spent the last 6 years infiltrating the Oparas and her guides, guessing the episode suit on aim to unseal the stolen episode, but there enough of you exist. Great for good fun, the Sloppy Dog episode is too powerful for me alone. Sloppy Dog needs higher help more than ever. Please, they need to clap for Sloppy Dog. Start helping. No, it's the only way to defeat Jacker to yourself. Helping hand to what is useful. I will win. Sloppy Dog give back the episode. You're not after it. Oh, see, Stefan. Yeah, I will win. Sloppy Dog give back the episode. You're not after it. It's a fluff.
Wait, I think I can smell something else. It smells like prayers and vitamins.
Could it be? It's him! It's the Hulkster! He's here to save us!
Fools! Even though this is clearly as close to perfection as a mortal body has ever gotten, he is still just mortal. He is so far beneath me that I could destroy him before you could even say—
We sure were lucky that Hulk Hogan showed up and soundly defeated Majora in that Loser Leaves Town match. That's the last we'll be seeing of him.
And even more impressively than that, he then kicked the moon back into its natural orbit and gave us a ride back to Earth in his space Ferrari.
What a satisfying and narratively fitting conclusion to our
10-year
journey.
It's only been 3 days!
10 years.
Oh, my head. Wait, the mask, it's gone. At last I'm free of that nightmare. Oh, I can finally return home to my loving family and get back to my humanitarian work.
Hold it right there, sir. You're under arrest for spending the last 3 days mooning the whole town. You're going away for a long time.
I didn't moon anyone. What I was doing was attempted genocide.
Oh. Well, that's much worse, you monster. Now let's get you to the jail before it closes.
Wait, you've got it all wrong, officer. It wasn't me. It was the mask. The mask made me do it.
Oh, sure. Watching early 90s Jim Carrey made me want to commit all that murder. That's the oldest excuse in the book.
No, not the timeless classic movie. An actual evil, magical, mind-controlling mask. I got it from that guy. He'll tell you.
Is that true, sir?
Oh, quick question before I answer that. What kind of punishment would this kid get for attempted world destruction without the aid of an evil, magical, mind-controlling mask?
He'd get several life sentences, sir.
I see, I see.
And, hypothetically, what kind of punishment could someone like me expect for hypothetically selling an evil, magical, mind-controlling mask with untold destructive power that I was fully aware of to a defenseless child? Hypothetically.
I don't know, like an hour's community service?
An hour? Why, that's long enough to have sex like 60 times!
And a 10-rupee fine!
I've never seen this boy in my life, officer, and I don't sell masks! What even is a mask? In fact, I was never here at all. Ooh, penis.
Well, his story checks out. Off to jail with you, Skull Kid.
Wait, I'm confused. So, is he like a ghost or something?
I don't even want to know what his deal was anymore.
Well, now that the world is safe again, I guess my job here is done. Time to head for the horizon and see what new adventures await. Maybe I'll get a big head and take up sailing. You ready to go, Navi?
Actually, I think maybe I should stay here with my brother. He's been through a lot, and besides, the adventuring life just isn't for me, you know? Plus, we should really make sure Skull Kid can get out of prison.
Oh, okay. So I guess this is goodbye, then.
Yeah, I guess it is.
Huh. You know, we've been so close to the end for so long that I kind of convinced myself I wouldn't care whenever it all finally ended, but now that we're here, and I look back on all the laughs we had along the way, and how much fun we had, and all of the people we got to meet, now that I know it's over, it just feels so... Take care of yourself, okay, Navi?
Hey, listen, I know I got mad at you a lot, but I want you to know that I always knew your heart was in the right place, even if your head never was. So, even though we argued all the time, I genuinely consider you a true—
Wait, what did you just say?
I was saying that despite all our fighting, I still consider you a—
No, before that.
That I'm staying here with my brother?
No, after that.
Hey, listen?
Yeah. Navi would never say that. You're an imposter!
What? I never claimed to be this Navi person. In fact, I constantly told you my name is Tattle.
Well, if that's true, then why did I think you were Navi this whole time?
Because you're an idiot!
Oh, sure. Me an idiot. A likely story. As if I'd believe the crazy lies of an imposter. Goodbye forever, fake Navi.
I hate that tunic-wearing idiot. You know, this misunderstanding never would have happened if all of you had just clapped to believe in Slappy Dog.
How the hell do you get this door open?